had no disease or very mild disease. Only a small percentage were ever developing any form of paralysis.
By the way, my grandmother, who's 89, you know, just beautiful, wonderful, smart person, she was given the first polio vaccine and then a month later got polio and it ate half the muscle on her body. But sorry, just go ahead.
Yeah, and this is one of the things that was the big scandal at the time, was that the vaccine itself eventually was causing virtually all the reported cases of polio, not a wild-type virus. And one of the big puzzles was that the virus seemed to be affecting the wealthier people, the upper economic class, than poor neighborhoods, which normally we'd see just the opposite. And what they discovered was that poor kids get a lot of normal infections, and so they have good, strong immune systems. Whereas the wealthier kids were being protected against these diseases by avoiding the infections and getting the vaccines, and therefore their immune system was very poor and couldn't react to it. And this is we're seeing this magnified many times over now, where there's just this, an unending push to vaccinate for every known disease, even childhood diseases that are quite mild. You know, when I grew up, everybody got measles, mumps, chicken pox. All of these things were very common. That built our immune systems up. So as we became adults, we're more resistant to things like flu. And you know, I've never had a flu shot in my life. I've never had a serious case of flu. But we've weakened everybody's immune system so severely now from all of these things, poor diet, things that we know suppress immunity, like the vaccines, the way they're given, that now people can't react. And what people don't know about vaccines, and most doctors don't know, but it's well demonstrated in medical literature, is that the vaccines shift your immune system to an immune suppression type state called a Th2 shift.
And you said that during the H1N1 scare, and then 6 months later, the Canadian government came out with two studies and said that it cut your immune system by as much or more than 50% to take that vaccine. So how did you know that at the time? I guess just because it had already been done before. I mean, you already knew.
Well, the research had shown that that's what most vaccines do, is they shift your immune system to a weaker antiviral type immune system. Well, we know, for instance, if we switch over to the Ebola incident in Africa, well, what they don't tell the general public is that Africans almost all have parasitic infections, malaria, roundworms in their intestines, and that it has been shown by multiple studies, and several recent have come out in Nature magazine and Science, that this powerfully suppresses their cellular immunity, their ability to fight viruses. The Ebola virus itself invades the white blood cells that fight viruses and weakens the immune system further. So they're at a particularly vulnerable state. It's not that the virus is such a vicious killer. It's that the people that it's infecting have this immune suppression. Well, if you're taking the United States and injecting people with so many vaccines that you're keeping them in a constant state, just like the Africans, that now you're switching everybody to this Th2 immune suppression, then everybody in the United States becomes more susceptible as well. And no one's talking about that. Now, a lot of scientists know that, but they're afraid to speak out because their careers would be ruined.
Well, that's what I was about to throw out. Look at how they get comedians fired from State Farm commercials. Sure. Just because in their private life they say, man, something's going on with these vaccines, or America's becoming fascist. But you know this in the literature. Other medical doctors know it. My dad's an oral surgeon and a chemist, but you know, he told me this stuff when I was a kid. So it's obviously not a secret with people that are learned, but then I've got family that are other medical doctors that write articles for the newspaper, you know, promoting vaccines, saying, you know, safe and effective, no problems, don't listen to people that say you know, it's the law when it isn't the law. Because I'm a good doctor, and I'm Harvard educated, and you don't tell me I'm wrong, and that's a bunch of quackery. But then I go read all the mainline studies, the inserts. You are really covering what's mainline science. How can there be a disconnect between a Harvard-educated pediatrician and then a brain surgeon like yourself, when all you're doing is covering the body of the most scientific, respected literature?
Well, the problem is most physicians don't read scientific literature. They read clinical studies, and they read it in only a handful of journals. For instance, pediatricians read their journal and a couple other journals, but that's it. So most of their information they're getting from the vaccine manufacturers, they're getting from their pediatric, what I call a trade union. And so they're not getting scientific information. They're getting propaganda.
Sure. I mean, in the journal, you got a Gardasil ad, you got two or three other ads, and then right next to it, an article about how great Gardasil is. I mean, this is not rocket science.
Well, and the thing is, you see, what I do is I spend a lot of time delving deep into mechanisms by which all this occurred. And I just finished a couple of weeks ago lecturing to a group of pediatricians, teaching them this mechanism. And in the audience were a number of scientists who do excellent science, and they agreed. They said that, you know, the mechanism you're describing is right on target. Well, when you hear these doctors who get up and say it's completely safe and there's no mechanism by which it could cause it, they don't know what they're talking about, because there is a very firm, well-demonstrated scientific method by which these vaccines are causing brain damage, prolonged brain inflammation, and excitotoxicity in the brain that goes on for decades, possibly a lifetime, that has the potential of increasing a number of neurodegenerative diseases like Alzheimer's, Parkinson's, ALS. And what shocked me is I cannot believe, since my career, and it goes back a good ways, I have never seen so much neurological disease in people. We're just seeing an explosion of Alzheimer's and Parkinson's and ALS. You know, when I was a resident, we had to look around hard to find a case of ALS. Now they're everybody, everywhere. Everybody knows somebody that has a friend or a relative that has ALS. It's just unbelievable. And yet the medical profession, I'm talking about the clinical practicing doctor, he's totally clueless as to the mechanism by which you could produce this. Yet in experimental animals, we can produce all of these neurological diseases by stimulating the immune system in ways that resemble vaccination, particularly the sequential excessive vaccination will produce this progressive neurodegeneration, just like we're seeing clinically.
Well, I worked for a large animal vet off and on for 3 years, and this was 25 years ago. And he, back then, he, one day a week at his clinic, he would take dogs and cats out in the country. And people would come in, and he'd say, you don't need a shot every year. You know, they need them every 3 years max. Some of these vaccines work 10 years on a dog or a cat. And they'd say, but I'm supposed to get it every year. And he'd say, no, you don't need that. And then he would explain to me, we see them have convulsions. We see them have autoimmune disorders. We see their allergies, especially in purebreds. And then now, of course, in the last decade, vets lobbied to get it to every 3 years. Now the vaccine companies are pushing back through the veterinary associations to make it at the state level mandated every year. Literally just to make money. But the vets knew this, Dr. Blaylock, 25 years ago.
Yeah, I hear from a lot of veterinary experts who tell me that they're seeing a terrible deterioration of the dogs and the cats from these vaccinations. Because just like humans, every time they can think of a new vaccine, they give it to them. And they're seeing this terrible deterioration. And it's the same sort of disorders we're seeing in humans. We're seeing brain degeneration. We're seeing an explosion of autoimmune diseases in the animals. Well, that's exactly what we're seeing in humans. We're seeing an explosion of autoimmune diseases of every kind. They're occurring at early ages. We're seeing increased MS, lupus, all of these autoimmune disorders. We have good explanations as to how the vaccine would do that. We have demonstration in our scientific studies of producing these very same diseases by vaccination. And yet the intimidation by the pharmaceutical companies and the government and link with pharmaceutical companies, scientists are terrified to speak out. And what they did to Andrew Wakefield is one of the reasons that doctors are so terrified to open their mouth and say, hey, look, millions of people are having their lives destroyed and their health destroyed by this crazy vaccine policy. I mean, we're not even reasonable now. They're wanting to give 150 vaccines over a lifetime. Well, you can't do that to an animal and not destroy the animal's health. And you can't do it to a child or a human being. A child gets about almost 40 different vaccines by the time they start school. Well, now, after they're in school, they want them to get even more vaccines. And when they go to college, they want more vaccines. If they go into the medical profession, they say you can't enter a hospital unless you get a flu shot every year.
Isn't this the heart of tyranny? Because if you talk to the brain surgeons, the medical doctors, the vets, they'll all tell you the same thing. The inserts on a lot of the vaccines admit it doesn't even protect you. More studies out that hepatitis vaccines attack the liver. Why are we giving newborn babies? Getting to the heart of this, Dr. Blaylock, they've had decades now to know this is going on. Instead, they're ramping it up. Until 6 years ago, no medical doctor I talked to would ever vaccinate a pregnant woman. So they doubled down and said pregnant women need extra. So instead of admitting that they've been caught in this eugenics policy, is what I believe it really is, and you've documented that as well, instead they seem to be doubling down. What's at the bottom of this rabbit hole? What is the vaccine agenda really about?
Well, before I answer that, I think without question, the vaccinating of pregnant women, which they say they should be vaccinated during any stage of their pregnancy, is the most absolute, insane, anti-scientific, unsupportable idea anyone could have come up with. Now, we have overwhelming evidence that immune stimulation during pregnancy increases the risk of that child being born with later developing autism or schizophrenia about six-fold to seven-fold higher. Now, we know that. We know miscarriages are increased. Yet they're carrying out this insane policy of telling every woman to get a vaccine. Now, the reason they're doing that is because they can't even interpret the scientific studies, which found that if women develop the flu or develop an infection, a serious infection during pregnancy, it increases the risk of autism and schizophrenia in the baby. But the studies found it's not the virus. It's the immune reaction.
Yes.
That causes it. It's interleukin 6. And that you can produce it without a virus just by stimulating the immune system. Well, a woman's risk of getting a serious infection during her pregnancy is pretty small, but they're calling for stimulating the immune system of every pregnant woman in the United States.
Unbelievable.
How insane is that?
Well, because
it's on. I believe that the doctors that know this, the scientists that know this, will just sit by and let them destroy the lives of millions of unborn babies, and knowing that the science strongly supports that this is the most insane idea anyone could ever come up with. For number one, the flu vaccine during pregnancy, the flu vaccine is ineffective for most people, and particularly during pregnancy, the vaccine is going to be a lot less effective. So, but it will stimulate those cytokines that produce this abnormal development of the brain that produces autism and schizophrenia. So how many schizophrenics and autistic children are we going to have another 5 years from now after they've started this insane policy?
Unbelievable. The neurological disorders, the mental illness, every metric is going parabolic, straight up like a rocket. And when we come back, we'll get your answer, because you just set that up with, is it on purpose? Well, at this point, we know it is, because they know. I mean, every doctor I've talked to goes, yes, it's true. We know you don't vaccinate pregnant women. Everybody knew that. So why do they say in articles I have, women need extra? I mean, just give a pregnant woman extra. They just need it. It's a doubling down. It's an over-the-top evil. It's a full commitment. And it is just devilish. Dr. Blaylock is our guest.